No one alive remembers World War I. It ended on the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month of the year 1918. Its death toll was almost 16 million soldiers and civilians. In the midst of all the chaos, we found man's best friend.
Well, they had an incredible role. They had many tasks during the war, and they are kind of some of our unsung heroes.
That's Doran Cart, the senior curator at the National World War I Museum in Kansas City, Missouri.
This museum is the only museum in the United States specifically for the history of World War I.
During the war, it's estimated 50,000 dogs were pressed into service. Doran says dogs were some of the war's hardest and most trusted workers.
They were used for carrying supplies forward. But their main real effort in action was as medical service. And especially with the French, they were actually trained to find wounded soldiers. And they carried basically first aid kits with them.
Often, dogs could get to soldiers on the battlefield when medics couldn't. Dogs also served as invaluable message carriers.
In our exhibit about communications, we do have a messenger dog collar. And it had a little tube in the front, had a screw-on lid, and it could slide a message in. The opposing armies, the frontline troops, were reticent to shoot dogs. And so they could usually get through as messengers where humans could not.
Dogs of all breeds and sizes were pressed into service. Larger dogs often performed sentry duties, but smaller dogs performed cherished services for the troops in the trenches, like delivering cigarettes.
Yeah, especially the smaller dogs, the hunters, the terriers and things like this, they use them as rat killers.
Rats carry disease, and they gnaw it into food and supplies.
There are some great pictures in some of the publications of just rows and rows of rats that these little dogs had caught.
Another thing that again, didn't think about, the dogs with African-American troops, we forget that, you know, back then the troops were still segregated.
That's correct. They were segregated in most aspects of activity. I know the photograph you're talking about. It says the fellas sitting there and they have the little dog in their lap. And then that was really the most important aspect of dogs in World War I were as friends.
And it wasn't just the Allied troops they helped.
They were important in all the armies. Dogs didn't really choose sides. There was, of course, the famous German flyer, the Red Baron, Baron von Richthofen. He had his dog he took from home with him into the service, and it was called Moritz. He loved this dog. He'd even take him up in the airplane with him.
If you're interested in learning more about the role dogs played in World War I, the museum offers lots of online resources.
We have a general kind of information website at theworldwar.org, and you can get general information, but we also have our online collection.
It's a fascinating resource for all kinds of information about one of the deadliest conflicts of all time, a struggle that was often referred to as the war to end all wars. For Pet Pals TV, I'm Steve Schweitzer.